Wrapping up, just want to get those last comments in, which related to what we've been talking about here at the Fox Business Network throughout. The president saying at the very end of those questions that, no, I don't think we're going to have a trade war. I don't think so, in answers to a reporter's questions in the Oval Office of the White House. All right. Let's talk about this. The market's obviously rallying today. It was down a lot earlier. It's up now. And we have market watchers Michael Block, David Benson, and Melissa Armo all here in the studios with us, listening in on those comments. Good to see all of you. Melissa, I don't know if you want to take the first shot at this, but the president saying we're not backing down, okay, saying NAFTA's a disaster, which he said many times. I hesitate, but seems to be saying, even though his trade advisor said the opposite, but between his tweet this morning and those comments, that these tariffs are a negotiating tactic when it comes to NAFTA. How do you read into it?
Well, I'm a little bit confused this morning because last week it seemed like a done deal.
You're not the only one, trust me. But that's the lead. That's kind of the latest read on it, I think. But yeah, we're all confused.
Yeah, anything's possible with Trump. The way I'm reading it is maybe he hasn't made up his mind yet. But the one thing's for certain, he was just mentioning China.
Yeah.
You know, China is a good partner for us in some regards because most of the companies on the S&P that trade do business with China. So the Chinese market, the U.S. markets were all tied together. You probably don't remember because the market had such a strong year in 2017 and probably nobody has this far of a memory. But I remember as a trader person, 2015, we had a huge fall in the summer in August of 2015. That was because of China. Then we started the year down really badly in 2016. That was because of China. So we really would have been stronger, I think, in 2016 if it wouldn't have been for that slow, weak start to the year. And it all was related to China. So to say that we have nothing to do with them is not fair. We do have a lot to do with them. But Trump has good points about wanting things to be a level
more
playing
fair.
Field.
We know that they have been dumping steel on the market for years at lower prices. That does affect the global price of steel. But David, what do you make of what the president's doing now? If you try to stick in the moment, which you have to do with this president, because it did seem last week and over the weekend that this was not a negotiating tactic. These tariffs are across the board for a, quote, very long time. But now he's talking about NAFTA and using, it seems like, these tariffs as leverage, right?
Well, it certainly seems that way. I think that it's extremely likely that he himself is moving minute by minute. I don't mean that a negotiating tactic is unfolding. I think that he himself is sort of being pulled a lot of
different directions. Seen him do that on other issues.
By my count, there's about 20 advisors who he deeply respects and has received input from,
right,
from his campaign through early part of presidency that are vehemently against what he's doing. There are two that are for it. And one of them is somewhat tepid on it as well. Even Wilbur Ross at Commerce has said he didn't agree with it being totally sweeping, including Canada in it, along with China. So there's some real silly stuff going on, and I'm hopeful that he's in the process of unwinding it in a way that will help him save face.
Well, Peter Navarro's the other one you're obviously referring to. He is deeply, Michael, in favor of it. That does kind of lend some credence to the idea that maybe a Gary Cohn has gotten to him on this. I think it's, you know, we talked earlier, and Jonas Ferris brought this up, is that on other issues, it's easier to get to this president, but this is one he really does believe in and has a record for a long time of at least talking about these protectionist measures.
His mantra is, I promised this and now I'm doing it. Look at me. I'm actually keeping my promise, whether it's a good decision or not. We can talk about Navarro and Ross on one side, maybe Gary Cohn's on the other side, but the really relevant person we heard from today was Speaker Ryan.
Yeah.
Speaker Ryan saying he has concerns about this because he's listening, he's watching the economic reality of this, Connell, and he's saying, wait a minute, we have an election. We have a midterm election that we're in danger of losing in November. We're losing ground. People are seeing through this, and maybe some steel workers think they should be happy about this, but there's a whole bunch of consumers and manufacturers and people who work for them,
people
who consume goods, who are not happy about this.
A lot more people
consuming. It does not make sense.
Steel than making it, certainly, as we've seen those numbers played out the last few days.
The problem is we can't lose those industries. I mean, I will say, if you look at those stocks, I mean, AKS, United Steel, I mean, these companies are in downtrends, long downtrends for 10 years more.
Yep.
And we can't lose those industries. And so Trump is trying to do something about keeping them intact. I mean, it's one thing to import certain things, but we need to be manufacturing more of it here and support those industries.
The steel production levels have been flat for 30 years. Nucor's stock is up 500% in the last 16 years. U.S. Steel's profits have tripled. The reality is that China represents 2% of our imported steel. This is just the wrong way to go about these things.
Other arguments. We got to go now, unfortunately, because of the comments that we took live. So we appreciate all three of you coming on and then being flexible with us. We'll be right back. More Cavuto Coast to Coast in just a moment.